Alright, so I'm starting off with taking my Tarte Amazonian Clay Foundation in shade Fair Sand. Yeah. And putting all over my face like that, just because I feel like that's the best way it applies. Then I'm taking a modern brush that looks like that. It actually works really well. I was scared it wasn't going to. Then I'm just going to put more foundation where I feel like I need more coverage. And I don't really rub the foundation in with the brush. I more pat it just because I feel like if I rub it, the brush kind of takes away the foundation. Then I'm going to cream contour with another little brush and a concealer palette that I stole from my mom. So, and it looks really dark and all that right now on my face, but it blends out to like nothing and it actually looks okay, so. And blending it out with a damp beauty sponge. I'm also more of a fan of like a harsh contour, so I mean if you're not, then that's you. Then I'm taking my Tarte Shape Tape concealer and kind of like highlighting but also concealing at the same time, you know. And this is in their lightest shades, and so you guys can see how light I am. And I put it on my eyelids to also prime my eyelids, eyeshadow, you know. And I do the concealer after I cream contour because otherwise I feel like it just blends all together, and I just like how this looks better than having it. Then blending them both out at the same time. And then I blended out the concealer under my eyes and I set it right away with powder because then if I don't, I will crease really bad. Same with my eyelids. And then I basically set my whole face the same way just because that's how I feel like it sets the best because I have really oily skin. And my face doesn't get as shiny whenever I do it like this. Then I'm going to powder contour with the NYX contouring kit and an angled brush. And I'm taking the two shades that were on the right, and kind of mixing them together and putting it on my cheekbones and on my jawline. And I'm taking the like third shade to the right and putting that on my forehead. I'm taking the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder on a like big e.l.f. powder brush and blending it out even more so that way it's not too harsh, but you know, you still see it. Oh yeah, I also have eyebrows now. I tried filming it, but my hand just kept getting in the way, so I just cut it out. So I'm taking a small Real Techniques concealer brush and contouring with the third shade from to the right, the same shade I used on my forehead, and blending it out with a big powder brush. Taking the Modern Renaissance palette, and I'm going to take the very light shade, I think it's called Tempera, and putting it all over my eyelids to also kind of make it easier to blend the eyeshadow more. I'm taking Warm Taupe and putting it in my crease with a kind of dense but also fluffy brush. I don't know. It's just... came in a set that I got from that someone got me and didn't have a name. And if it did, it was probably just called eyeshadow brush, but it works really well for me for this stuff. So just use whatever brushes you're comfortable with, all that stuff. Then I'm taking a different brush with no product on it at all and blending it out like more so to pop the harsh line from my skin tone to the warm tone and then all the other colors because that doesn't look good to me. I'm pretty sure I was just looking for a product that I couldn't find, but it turns out it was right in front of my face right there anyways. So, yep, that's what I was doing. I think I was looking for the blush. Anyways, I'm taking an Urban Decay eyeshadow priming potion, and I'm gonna, like, put it all over my lid as a base for the gold eyeshadow I'm gonna use. And I do this instead of concealer because the primer gets, like, tacky, so I feel like it sticks better than the concealer, and I've done it with concealer before, and it sticks better with this to me, but if you're happy with how it looks with concealer, then stick with that. And I'm taking a L'Oreal Invaluable eyeshadow in shade Eternal Sunshine, I think it was. And a flat e.l.f. smudge brush. And I'm gonna pack it onto the primer. And this eyeshadow did have fallout for me, but I also kind of like crush it up to where it's more of like a loose pigment than a pressed eyeshadow. So, I'm also blending it out on my eyelid with a small e.l.f. concealer brush, I think it's called. I really love the e.l.f. brushes, if you can't tell. That's like my one favorite thing from them. But everything else I feel is more of a hit and miss type of thing. I like their liquid liner too, that's not that bad. It doesn't make my eyes water as much as other brands. Then my camera's gonna cut out soon, I think. I know it cuts out close to this part. But anyways, I'm just kind of blending the gold and warm taupe together while putting more warm taupe on my brush as I feel like I need to. And then I'm putting it on like the outer third of my eye to blend it with the other colors I'm gonna put there. And then I'm taking, I think the shade was like golden ochre or something like that, and putting it on top of the warm taupe to give it more of the yellow tone. Now I'm taking red ochre on a like round fluffy, short fluffy brush. I don't know. There's like some e.l.f. It's called an e.l.f. blending brush, I think. And I'm putting it just on the outer corner and kind of blending it into my face, but I'm not taking it in that far. And I'm slowly building up the color instead of putting a lot on my brush and then blending it out. Because this is just how I feel works the best for me. Then my camera cut out right then. Okay. But after I did the red on both eyes, I just took the dark brown eyeshadow in the palette, which I will show later on.